Hey, it's Anna here, your digital techie Jenny. Welcome to my another tutorial from the DIY series, and this time I want to show you how you can add your branding to the Mailchimp signup box and following email sequence. I'm actually getting a little bit frustrated when I go to websites that have beautiful branding, and when I sign up for a newsletter or a free goodie, what I'm getting next is a default, grey, terrible Mailchimp sequence. So let's change that. What I need you to have at hand is your Mailchimp account, Canva, your branding assets such as logo and colors, and then we need a little bit of text for your emails and about 20 minutes of free time. So let's start. We need to go to Mailchimp account. I assume that you have your list already created. If you don't, check out my channel. I will post a video soon how to create a list in Mailchimp. So we need to go to that list. Let's click on the name, and then we need to go to signup forms, and that's where the fun begins. We need to go to general forms. And let's scroll down to take a look, and that's what we see, default Mailchimp signup box. This is exactly the same when it comes to the email sequence. So what we will be doing here is changing that to something more sexy. So let's make it beautiful and go to design. The background box here where the hex code for the color is what we see here. So I want to go for white, so I need to type 3 F's here, and that will go to white. The next thing I want to do is change that default list name to a nice banner. So I want to use image here, so we can click on that. And then we can either import from URL or upload image, but first we need to create that. So let's go to our Canva account and then use the custom dimensions. We can go for 600 by let's go 280, that should do, and then click design. If you are familiar with Canva, you should know that you can upload your logo here or some text or images you want to use for a background. So what I wanted to do is use that branding graphic that I use on my website. So let's just make it nice and fit here. I need to make that a little bit like this. Perfect. And then I want to use my logo. Let's paste it there. Now I want to add a little bit of text. There we go. And let's say welcome. Black is not a perfect color, it doesn't look good, so let's switch it to white. And then I need to add a little bit more space between the letters, so let's do that. That's perfect. Now I just need to move it around a little bit. There we go. Let's add a little bit more text there, and again make that white. Welcome to my newsletter. Perfect. The next thing, we need to download it to our computer, and because we want to go for the high quality, let's go for the PNG. Then go back to our Mailchimp account, click on upload, and that should already land in my downloads somewhere. As you can see, I have loads of files here. Let me just type the name. Oh, there we go. So here we have our graphic. We can even link to the website or Facebook or Twitter, whichever you want people to go when they click on that. And then just save and scroll down. There we go. We have our graphic here. It looks much better. Now let's have a look on the form itself and the fonts. So first thing I want to do is remove the last name. Who wants to give us a last name? So let's get rid of that. And I don't like that font. This is what we have here. So let's go to design again. We need to go to forms. And this is where the fun will happen. Field labels, that's the font that I don't like. It's Arial, so let's go for Georgia. And the color, let's go for a little bit darker like that. Okay. We don't like the subscribe to list button color, so let's change that. We have the buttons. And now you need to have your color, your branding hex colors. So I have mine here, and this is a pink one. So I want to use that. You can also change the text color. And there you go, it's pink now. Let's change the Harvard State color as well. I want to go for my teal. So let's grab that. Here we go. It's teal. Let's test. There we go. So I think that's pretty much. The last thing we want, we can change as well, is the Mailchimp logo. It's just called Monkey Rewards. I want to go for this one. If you will go for the premium account, then you won't need to add the badge, Mailchimp badge. Okay, so I think that looks pretty good. Let's just have a look what else we can change. That's all good. Header is done. Auto wrapper is none. Let's just change the font for default text to Georgia, and the link style to my pink color. Let's take a look on forms. We have our buttons. That's done. Again, we have Arial. I want Georgia. And a darker color. Then we have required. So I want that to be my pink. That's hidden. Let's change the help text to pink. And arrows to pink. And that should be more or less all. So now let's go to the email sequence. The next thing we need to adjust is the thank you page. So this is the page people will land after they fill in the form. And what's cool, Mailchimp is also giving us chance to put a URL. So if you have a thank you page on your website, you can just paste URL here. If you don't have a thank you page, what I would recommend you is add a little bit more information here in that box instead of almost finished. It doesn't really tell people anything, and they normally don't notice this little text here. So what I will do, click on edit and then add information about what they need to do. So the next step they need to do is go back to the email box and look out for confirmation email from you and click the button in that email so they will get the goodie or sign up to your newsletter. So you can get creative and craft some good message here to let people know what they're supposed to do. Next thing we need to adjust is the confirmation email. And this is the one that will land in people's inboxes after they sign up. So who wants to confirm subscription, right? If they're signing up for a goodies, they don't want to confirm subscription, they want to receive the goodies. So again, what I will encourage you is edit that information. So what you can do here is add a little bit information about yourself, welcome them, and then ask to click that button below. Once you do that, click save and close. Next thing what you can adjust is this information here, so you can make that bigger if you wish. You can change the font, let's make it bigger, and you can even add some images here as well if you wish. Just click somewhere you want to add an image. You can add your signature, for example. Let's see if I have my signature. I have a thank you image here, so let's use that. Make it a little bit smaller. And save it here. How cool that looks, isn't it? Nice, huh? So now once we have that done, we need to go up again. We can forget about the confirmation capture, but then we have the confirmation thank you page, and again it's a page that people will land after they click the subscribe button in that email we just customized a second ago. And in that case you can also add a thank you page URL if you have another one created, or you can just adjust these tags here. Again, who wants to know that subscription is confirmed? Put something much more exciting here. And you can also include here links. So my tip is, if you're doing some free goodies and you don't want to pay for the automation, you can use that. So you can put here is the ebook. And then you can make that link. So put the link to your ebook download. Whatever you have your ebook, you can add it here. So let me just grab this and we can pretend it's a URL for the PDF. And then paste it here. Save and close. And there we go, a link, and they can download from that page. How cool is that? Again, this bit you can adjust. The only thing you need to leave as it is this code, this merge tag, because this one will add the list and address, and this is required by Mailchimp. Again, you can add something more exciting here. Let's use an image and check what I have here. Thank you as my signature. Can use that one as well and just paste it there we go. Save and close. The dimension is a little bit too big, so we can adjust that. Let's make it 500. And then align center. There we go. Now it looks better, but it didn't adjust. So you can just play around with it. Normally what I do is use this. It doesn't want to. Okay, let's do some spaces and then use my little trick. we go. It's perfectly centered now. And the last bit we need to look at is the final welcome email. So again, here you can welcome people to your tribe. You can send them some goodies here in that email. You can give them some core information. But remember, if you want that email to be sent, you need to tick that box. Otherwise, it's not gonna go. So do that and then play with the information here. You can change the text, you can add links, you can add images, you can do whatever you wish, just play around it, make it look sexy and part of your brand, then save and close. And that is pretty much what we're supposed to do. Let's just quickly go back and check how it will look when it lands in our email box. So let's copy the signup URL. There we go. That's our signup box. You don't necessarily need to use that if you're using a plugin or something different, but this is like a standalone and we can just test that. Subscribe. Look what will happen. Okay, so we're having nice subscribe thank you page. Well, I haven't changed anything here, but you will do and it will look much better. So now I need to go to my Gmail account. And there we go. I need to click on that. And hey, I have some cool looking email. Yes, I want to subscribe me to this list. And then again, I have my banner, I have my nice branded font and a graphic. So you get the idea, we've done pretty good job. And if I will go back, you should have another email here saying subscription confirmed. Unfortunately, we cannot do anything about that, but at least it looks much better to default Mailchimp email. I hope you find this information helpful, and if you did, please subscribe to my channel. I promise to post more useful tips and DIY techniques, so stay tuned. Bye.